It's Laura, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a complete cosplay from the musical Cats. So, the new movie notwithstanding, which I have a lot of thoughts on, I've been a fan of the musical Cats for as long as I can remember. The film version that I am familiar with is the 1998 filmed stage movie, and I was born in 1998, so as you can imagine, I cannot remember a time when I did not know that Cats existed. So whatever you want to say about the new movie, it's fine. Whatever your feelings about the musical are, it's fine. I, for one, love Cats the musical. I love the songs. I love Andrew Lloyd Webber. And above all, I love the costumes and the makeup. Now, the first time I did this was in 2014, I think it was, and my sister and I cosplayed Rumpelteazer and Victoria to go see Cats at a theater. And that was very fun. They all thought that we were part of the performance and we had to tell them, no, actually, we did not perform. But thanks. But with the new movie and the new tour that I've seen now twice, and I'm going to see again later in the upcoming year. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how I made two of my newest Cats costumes that Deanna and I wore to go see Cats actually last June. So the cats that I'm going to be showing you in this video are going to be Jemima.
Can you find your way blind when you're lost in the street?
And Cassandra.
Jellicle cats have moonlit eyes.
But of course, you can just follow these techniques and whatnot for whatever cat that you want to make. Jemima just happens to be my favorite. And Deanna took a What Cat Am I from Cats the Musical, and I knew she was gonna get Cassandra, and guess what? She got Cassandra. So I've broken up this video into each of the different parts for making a cat's costume. The cat's costumes, just like the show, are very complex, and there's a whole lot of different parts to them, so if you want to just find out how to make a specific part, then you can just click the timestamp down below. But in general, what I'm going to be showing you is how to make the wigs, the tails, the unitards, collars, leg and arm warmers, and then finally the makeup that you can do before you go cosplay as a cat or perform as a cat or wear your cosplay to go see people perform as cats and then people think that you were actually the performers. So let's go ahead and I'll start showing you how to make your very own cat's costume. So we are going to start off with the iconic wigs. They're not as hard to create as you might think. The quick and dirty way to do this is to get some pantyhose, cut off the legs, and then sew them together to create a kind of bald cap. Next, we're going to be using this kind of synthetic fiber called kankalon or kanekalon. I'm not quite sure how to pronounce it, so let me know if you know how to pronounce it. But it's basically this super nice, furry-looking texture that looks the most similar to yak hair, which is what the original Broadway costume wigs have. But since I am not in supply of a great number of yaks, I'm going to be using this kind of fiber instead. I'll provide a link in the description to where you can buy it from. I buy the jumbo braids, and people use this to like put in their dreads and stuff like that. You get a whole lot in a braid and you can cut it into little pieces and then glue it on, which is what we're going to be doing. The first thing you're going to do is after you have severed your legs from your pantyhose and you've sewed it up to make a bald cap, go ahead and put that on a wig mannequin and then you're going to cut off little flaps for the ears and glue them on the sides. And then we're just going to start gluing fur on. I partitioned off the wig cap using a Sharpie, just deciding like where I want black fur to be versus red fur. And basically I'm just using a bunch of reference images, which you can just look up on Google Images for whatever cat that you're doing. And after you have decided where you want all your colors to be, then just cut pieces of fur. Mine are probably about the width of my hand, and then you just start gluing them on. So the first thing that I do on the wig is always the ears. And so basically what you're doing is you're just making this tuft, this circle of glued pieces, and then you're going to tie them all together at the very end and create a little nub. You can use a rubber band to create this nub, and so after you do that, then you can get another fine piece of the kankalon, and then you can just wrap it around to cover up the rubber band. After you have formed the ears, it's nice to always set them with some hairspray before you start going and doing everything else. Next, it's just super easy. You just glue and glue and glue all these different colors of wefts.
After you have the entire thing covered, which will take several hours, then you're just going to brush it, remove all of the loose fur or the loose hair. And then you're just going to style your wig, which is always fun. Just get some scissors and start trimming away. One thing that is good to be careful about when you're gluing on your wefts of hair is to make sure that you don't glue them all side by side without leaving any kind of space. You want your wig to have some stretch in it, so you need to leave areas between each weft, like a little bit of pantyhose, to allow that kind of stretch. Also, you want to make it less afro-y just because that doesn't look as natural for the cat's costumes. You don't need to, you know, fill the whole thing up. You don't want it to look like a sphere. It's the same kind of technique for Cassandra's wig. Since she is more of a sleek cat, she has a little bit more specialized styling, like French rolls on the side of her head. You just leave those hairs longer and then you spray them with like a ton of hairspray, and then you just roll that hair up as if it was your own hair. Now, the tails are one of my favorite parts of the cat's costume, mainly because you basically just use a bunch of different scraps that you have. So these are all the different kinds that I'm going to be using. As you can see, I like a variety of textures, some like more furry, some stringy, and some your regular traditional wool yarns. For Cassandra, since she is more sleek, I'm using satin ribbon for her tail. So the first thing you're going to do is measure your waist. Then you're going to get some stretchy fabric. I'm using this leftover sparkly fabric that I have that is a knit fabric, so it stretches. And I'm just getting 3 long pieces of that and I'm braiding it together. You're going to make it a little bit smaller than your waist size. It will depend on the stretch of the fabric that you use for this. So for Cassandra, I'm going to be using pantyhose instead of fabric to make the braid. I just grabbed this sweater that I found at a thrift store and I'm cutting it into a bunch of little strips. Once again, I'm going to braid these strips for however long I want my tail to be, approximately 2 feet, 2.5 feet. After you braid this together, then you can just attach it to your waistband. There's a variety of ways you can do this. I think I just used hot glue and maybe tied a couple of pieces on there. Next, you're just going to get a whole bunch of your scrap yarn, then you're going to cut a whole lot of pieces, once again about the length of your hand, and then you're just going to tie them over and over and over again in various patterns onto the braid, which is going to be the base of your tail. I really don't have a lot to say about the unitards other than I just bought these blank unitards from Amazon. It's made out of lycra, which is like a kind of spandex. I got a brown one for Cassandra and a white one for Jemima.
They're the same picture.
What's up?
Now, the authentic Broadway unitards, they're hand-tailored for each of the actors, and they don't open in the back. They have more, like, snaps on the shoulders. But I didn't feel like going to all that work. I also didn't feel like actually dyeing it. I'm just using these unitards that I bought that have zippers in the back, which are fine for our purposes. They have closed feet, they have open hands, and then I'm just using fabric paint, and I'm painting all over them. Once again, just use reference images for whatever cat you're using, and, you know, traditional blending techniques and feathering whenever you're painting kind of fur, and you should be good to go. Now, the collars were actually the very first part of the costumes that I started to make, and they're so much fun because you got to include like a lot of little intricate details. So what I'm doing for Jemima is I'm using this kind of faux leather fabric that I had left over from something, and it's naturally this sort of maroonish color, but that's not gonna work. So what I'm doing right here is I'm just using a little bit of fabric painting medium and then some black acrylic paint, and I'm just quickly going over it. Now, Jemima has spikes on her collar, which makes her really cute, and I really wanted to use something that had a little bit of detail with it. So I'm using these filigree aluminum caps, which are used a lot in earrings or to make teardrop-shaped ornaments. I'm filling them in with hot glue. Since the filigree caps have little holes in them, I'm just rolling around this hot glue-filled cap in some glitter, which is just going to put glitter on the inside, on the outside, and all that jazz. So when the hot glue dries, you have this, basically you have this solid cone that's nice and glittery. I'm just going to use some super glue and glue it onto my strip of pleather. Jemima's collar also has these really cute little red rhinestones, so I'm just alternating between those and the spikes. I'm also including 3 snaps on the back so that I can adjust the tightness of the collar depending on who's wearing it. I'm also using little findings, jump rings, I think they're called, to serve as a base for each of the cones. Now for Cassandra, I am using this strip of suede that I just cut and then put some glitter on, because why not, to make Cassandra's kind of undulating wavy pattern. I'm just using a bit of suede cord and I'm hot gluing it in a wavy pattern onto this strip of suede. After that, I just found some cheap plastic pearls, and I'm just super gluing those in between each of the little waves on the collar. Like with Jemima, I also included some snaps on Cassandra's collar as well, so that you can adjust it depending on who's wearing it. Traditionally, a lot of cosplayers and people who actually make the Broadway costumes, I'm pretty sure they like crochet and knit the arm and leg warmers. I don't know how to crochet and I only know how to finger knit, and I also didn't want to take that long anyway, and I wanted to be thrifty. So what I did is I took that same sweater from before that I used for the tails, and I'm cutting off the arms, and I'm going to be using that as my leg warmers for Jemima. I'm tightening it a little bit however much I need, but I'm still making sure that I can fit it over my foot. I'm just taking this upholstery needle and my kind of shaggy looking yarn, and I'm just really messily just going through and sewing, you know, different kinds of stripes and stuff onto my leg warmers. And once again, I was also using a reference image for this. Reference images are really great. I don't go by them 100%, but they're super nice just to give you a rough idea of how you want your cat to look. For both Jemima and Cassandra, they don't actually have arm warmers, they have more of these like glove type things. So I got these opera gloves, which are just cheap long gloves, and we're gonna cut off the tips of them because they are cats and we need to be able to see their claws. I used these fabric markers and just drew a lot of vertical lines crisscrossing over them. On the ends of the gloves, I glued some more of this sort of textured ribbon just because that matches Jemima's kind of like fluffiness. And And for Cassandra, she has a much more smooth gradient on her gloves, and so I'm just using some fabric paint, and I'm painting a darker brown on the backside, and then a nice light brown on the inside. In order to do a very smooth gradient whenever you're fabric painting, you want to make sure that your fabric is already wet first, so that you're able to blend the colors. I'm choosing to use Mehron, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. It's like the sort of standard professional entry level theater makeup. You really don't need like a huge color palette. Honestly, the majority of colors and stuff I used were just like foundations, eyeshadows and stuff like that anyway. Then you can just look up a photo of your cat's face and follow it to the best of your ability.
Should I put this cap on now or later?
I would spritz your hair, with like hairspray just to get all the babies flyways.
The babies.
The babies. Time to do our makeup for the first time. And hope that it's not complete trash. And then I can help you adjust it if it's like weird.
Oh, mama, I can't see. Ew, that just looks like a ball sack in the back.
Bad at the end of this.
Goodbye. I'm deceased. Somebody's compensating. Alright, so it's about to get scary because I'm about to do my eyebrows.
Oh god, this feels really weird.
I want everybody to see. Time to shave my eyebrows off.
Two.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh yes.
It doesn't, I'm lying.
I don't know why I said yes.
It's hey, what's up? I look disgusting. I've always wanted to just wax an eyebrow off to see like if it would come off in an eyebrow shape.
Ooh, somebody's compensating.
How do I look, y'all?
Oh, that's hot.
My face itches, I'm fucked.
You know that one shot of Cassandra where she was like...
Wow! I'm so scared.
Why are there so many people outside today just...
compensate?
Oh shit, I can't be cute because I don't look cute.
You are like fierce though.
Hello.
Time to put on the wig.
Do you wear wigs?
No, I do not.
Have you worn wigs?
No, I have not.
Will you wear wigs?
Maybe.
When will you wear wigs?
So I'm going to be using spirit gum to attach the wig to my skin. Spirit gum is just a cosmetic adhesive that allows you to attach like prosthetic parts or allows you to firmly attach wigs to your head so that they don't fall off.
Hello. Beware of my huge nuts.
watching my video. I hope that it was informative if you ever want to make your own Cats cosplay. Did you like the new Cats movie? I have a lot of thoughts on it, like I said earlier. Overall, I would give it like a 65%. Like, I didn't hate it. There were certainly some parts that it was a no for me. But there were definitely other parts that I thought were likeable, entertaining, to say the least. I'm interested to see if other people who are fans of the show actually have informative opinions about the new movie. Critics, they just write off Cats and they don't even really understand it. It's nice to hear feedback on Cats productions from people who actually understand the show and can appreciate it for its musical complexity and, you know, all the costumes and makeup and stuff too. So let me know if you like Cats the Musical down below in the comments. If you don't, that's fine. I still do. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video, and if you want to see more creative random things that I'm doing in the future, please feel free to subscribe down below, and I will see you with a new video soon. Bye-bye!
So Deanna, how was your first live performance?
It was amazing. Everybody was sexy and I wanted to touch them. Not inappropriately, maybe mildly.
A lot of people thought we were in the show, which we're not.
That was so awkward.
The moment we've all been waiting for, to take off these wigs.
Oh my god. Now I just look weird and bald.